Hey, it's Martha Mikk again with a nice, easy project for the winter. Give these as gifts. They're fun to make. This is my son, Harry, doing the work for me today. He's going to distress this. This is the fun, one of the fun parts here. You don't have to do this, but it makes it interesting. It's just some wood that I found out in my backyard. My husband cut it up for me. We're gonna paint it a little bit. I'm trying to make a purple, a silvery purple. It's not the greatest color, but it does remind me of winter. So, a little Mod Podge, and this, you have the paint that will also seal your wood. Mix it up, apply it, and then we're going to wipe it a little bit with a rag, and it gives it like a stained rather than painted effect. So we're going to do both the top and all the sides. You don't have to do the back, because nobody's gonna see the back. The next step is the making of the snowflake. So what we want to do is measure our piece of wood, and this time we have it's about 7 inches, and we're going to divide that in half, and then we're going to subtract 3/4 of an inch from that number, and that's going to give us the dimension of our snowflake arm. This is going to be a snowflake that's cut in 6 identical pieces, pretty identical. I take a piece of paper, just the thinnest paper you can find. Well, within reason, I wouldn't use tissue. That's 6 inches long by the 2 3/4 dimension that we came up with through our little calculation there. And we're folding this first in half, then in thirds, and that gives you 6 folds there, 6 thicknesses. Then we're going to fold that in half one more time. So you see why you want your paper to be fairly thin. This is now 12 thicknesses. Harry is now drawing a little shape, and this is where you get creative. And I hope, because it's only paper, you'll cut out a few of these until you like what you get. Now you notice he has made that drawing along that last fold, the 12 thickness. And you want to be careful that you cut through all these layers. Because of the thickness, you will get some differences in your arms. What he's doing here is just cutting out a little bit of that main fold so he has a little more interest in his snowflake arms. So this gets more and more complicated as you make your snowflake from these 6 identical pieces. So you see, there he has his shapes. He's figuring out where he wants to position these. Now you could use a protractor, make everything 60 degrees, but we can do it by eye. We don't need to be crazy about this. This is supposed to be a relaxing craft. We had enough math at the beginning. So he's just gluing this down. Now remember, it's important that you completely cover the surface that you're going to adhere your paper with the Mod Podge. You don't want any air bubbles underneath there, any unglued places. And as you know, paper always expands when it's wet, and Mod Podge is largely water. So you're going to get some expansion, and when you see the bubbles pop up, push them down with your fingers, and as it dries, you continue to push that down. The paper will then shrink back to the size it was before, and the bubbles will disappear. Cover everything with Mod Podge. Harry liked the, I like the dabbing. He liked the streaking, the brush strokes. Here he is pushing down a couple of the bubbles. And now we're going to let this dry. And you can use a hairdryer if you want to dry it faster. He used a fairly thick layer of Mod Podge. You could use thin layers and put on a couple of them. And now for the embellishment. So we have some pearl paint and some silver paint. And he is just dabbing with a chopstick, that very sophisticated tool that you know I love. And he's making this completely his own. Now, like I said, you can try before you glue it down, or if you have lots of pieces of wood and you want to make more than one, because these make great gifts, you can just practice cutting out those snowflakes. The reason that I have used 6 different pieces is because it's much more difficult to cut out an entire snowflake, and it's harder to glue it down. So I like this idea of 6 individual pieces. And don't forget to sign and date your work. This is important. You want to remember when you made this, and if you give it as a gift, You want people to know who it's from. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, there are lots more crafts at the Patchogue-Medford Library. We hope to see you soon in person or virtually. Either way is great. Be well, and thank you again. Bye.